We've said it many times before, cameras are everywhere. Still, some of you may be skeptical. So, let's conduct a little experiment. I'm gonna go home, and you're gonna come along for the ride. Let's go.
Don't forget to take the puppies out.
Welcome to my house. This here's Ladybug. Say hi, Ladybug. Now, what did we learn? Well, if someone really wanted to, they could literally backtrack my every step from this door to that door. Now, of course, some of these cameras are intentional. This one, for example, I use it to keep an eye on my dogs when I'm not home. But what about the other times? Are we really being tracked by cameras in real time? Fauxrensics case number 25, the camera Dragnet. One of the most exciting scenarios in pop culture is chasing the bad guy. The tension gets ratcheted up even more when the person trying to get away is automatically tracked every step of the way by cameras. But is this fiction mimicking reality, or is this just another television and movie faux pas? Well, like most plot devices, this scenario is rooted in reality, to some degree at least. As we just demonstrated, it's very possible to trace a person's steps from point A to point B, given there are enough cameras that can be accessed in between. However, the trace can only be made after the journey has taken place, not in real time. And most importantly, the process isn't automatic. There has to be an investigator locating and meticulously combing through the huge amounts of footage from multiple sources to piece the journey together. Here to tell us more is the CEO of Rank One Computing, Brendan Clare.
Stories in the media right now, there's a misconception that, you know, surveillance systems are being set up that are real time, that are identifying people against large databases, and that's just simply not the case. The technology is a post-incident forensic tool. There's a human examiner that will manually compare the images with a lot of detail and effort. But the technology is not even to the point where you could issue a warrant for somebody's arrest based on this. This is a purely investigative lead. I think we all get it. Nobody wants to walk down the street and, you know, be spied on by our government. It's not what law enforcement's doing. And there's a very controlled process that doesn't violate people's privacy or rights that they can go through forensically post-incident to identify somebody.
So yes, cameras are everywhere these days, and the more prevalent they become, the more the odds of us being captured by one. Not literally captured, of course, just our images. The notion, however, that we're being tracked by cameras in real time is best left to television and movies,
and definitely Fauxrensics.